Hey everyone, it's Macca from Inside Gaming with Seagate. If you want to take your gaming laptop to the next level and upgrade the internal storage, we'll show you how. Let's get inside. Picking the right SSD is a matter of both personal preference and performance needs. And we've covered how to pick the right one for you in previous episodes. If you're uncertain on which drive to pick, check out our episodes on picking the right storage or what makes a good gaming SSD, which we'll link to. But from a technical standpoint, the first place we should start is by finding out what drive our laptop supports. For today's video, we'll be focusing on how to upgrade your laptop's internal hard drive to an SSD, using two Seagate SSDs as our examples, the FireCuda 120, which is a SATA SSD, and the FireCuda 510. Which is an M.2 NVMe SSD. If your laptop has a 2280 M.2 NVMe PCIe slot, then you'll be able to take advantage of the NVMe's blazing fast speeds. If your machine only has a 2.5-inch slot for storage devices, you'll likely want to upgrade to a 2.5-inch SATA SSD like the FireCuda 120. When in doubt, refer to your laptop's manual to determine what SSD interface, size, and format is compatible, as well as how many expansion slots are available. And if you're just adding an SSD to an empty slot, you can skip ahead a bit to the installation process. Now, don't be intimidated. You'll just need a screwdriver, a static discharge wristband, and a USB adapter. Your drive may be exposed to handling and electrostatic discharge hazards after unpacking. So make sure to keep the SSD in the protective sleeve until it's ready for installation, and always wear a properly grounded anti-static wrist strap throughout the entire installation process. Now, depending on the number of slots you have available, you may or may not need a USB adapter. For example, if you have a laptop running a 2.5-inch SATA drive and an empty M.2 NVMe slot, you can simply install the M.2 NVMe SSD into the slot and then clone one drive to another. As you might see, the laptop we're using to demonstrate this upgrade features an open M.2 NVMe slot. But for the purposes of this video, we'll pretend that it doesn't have an open slot. In that case, a USB adapter is necessary because we'll need to connect the new SSD first and then migrate the contents of your internal drive, including the operating system. We can do this easily with Seagate's free DiskWizard software, which allows us to clone one drive onto another. But since we can't clone the old drive after we've removed it, we'll have to do that first. There are plenty of USB adapters on the market, available for both 2.5-inch SATA SSDs and M.2 NVMe SSDs. We're going to be doing this with a SATA SSD today, but it's a similar process for an M.2 SSD. You'll just want to get the right adapter for your device. First, with your laptop powered up, plug your new SSD into the adapter, and then plug the adapter into the available USB port. Your machine should automatically recognize the device as if it were any external SSD. After you've downloaded and installed the DiskWizard software, launch the app and click Tools. Then click Clone Disk. In most cases, the automatic setting is appropriate, so click Next. Select your existing hard drive as the source disk and click Next. Then, select your new SSD as the destination disk. This will effectively format your new SSD, cloning your old hard drive, and erasing whatever content might be on the destination SSD. Click Next. Click Proceed, and DiskWizard will start the process. Seagate offers full DiskWizard documentation on their website, so check that out if you have any questions. Once the cloning process is completed, you're ready to physically replace your old drive with your new one. And because it's a clone, your laptop should recognize it as if it was always there and boot up Windows like normal. As always, your process may differ, so make sure you check your laptop's user manual. But for us, we're gonna power down our laptop and unplug it. You're encouraged to also remove your laptop battery to eliminate any residual power that may linger in your machine. Locate your hard drive panel and remove the cover with your screwdriver. Remove the old drive from its connection, removing any mounting screws for the old drive. Generally, there is one mounting screw at the bottom of an M.2 drive and four mounting screws at the corners of a 2.5-inch SATA drive. The FireCuda 120 slides right into place via the SATA connection bus on your laptop's motherboard. Replace the cover and the battery and plug it back in. Power up your laptop and it should boot like normal, but now with the speed and power of your SSD. One of the best things your SSD upgrade will give you is an immediate increase to your game boot times and your level and texture loads. Reach out to let us know how your upgrade is affecting your gameplay. Until next time, enjoy your upgrade and thanks for watching.